This storm made landfall early Sunday morning local time, and yet hours later it is still battering the Philippines' most populated island. We have seen lots of pictures throughout the day on Sunday of homes and neighborhoods dealing with flood water, with water levels several feet high in neighborhoods situated alongside riverbanks. The northern part of Luzon Island has borne the brunt of this storm, with thousands of people forced to evacuate their homes, mostly in rural communities along the country's coast. Dozens of evacuation shelters were set up by both the federal government and relief agencies like the Red Cross. Thousands of evacuees are now waiting out the storm in those shelters, and they could be waiting there for some time. This storm is moving at a very slow pace, basically meandering north. And that means that rain continues to fall on the island at a pace that could end up with some areas receiving more than a meter of rainfall. The northern part of this island is a very mountainous region, and so in addition to general flooding, rivers pushing over their banks, and a dangerous storm surge, the region also faces significant threat from landslides. Federal officials said landslides during the day on Sunday blocked roads leading to three towns in the hard-hit province of Aurora. Official Filipino state media said the military was doing their best to clear that area but was facing an uphill battle due to difficult conditions on the ground. The continued rain will make relief efforts and damage assessments that much more difficult as Filipinos wait for this storm to make its way out of the area. Matt Rivers, CNN, Hong Kong.